Wakey, wakey, time for bread to bakey. Hey, YouTube friends and family. We've decided to share with you my bread recipe. Now, my bread recipe comes from my mom, and it's the bread that she used to bake when I was a child. And I want to share it, because I have a new toy. I certainly do. Somewhere or another, out there in YouTube, there are angels. And angels often reach out and help those that need help, or they just do generous things because they want to. And I happen to come across a few. I have a new KitchenAid. And because of that, I don't have to worry about my wrist and my thumbs anymore. And having given up on making bread, I don't have to do that anymore. I've got something that needs it for me. So I'd like to share with you our recipe, and I hope you enjoy it. It's pretty simple. First off, I start with milk. I have 2 cups of milk, and I have 1 cup of water in this pan. And I'm heating the pan up to 110 degrees. Don't worry if you haven't got milk, because more often than not, I actually use 2 tablespoons of powdered milk with 3 cups of water. And that works perfect. Now, to my milk, once I get it the temperature I want, then I'll add my yeast and my sugar. Yeast loves sugar, and it will eat on the sugar. That's what causes it to work most efficient. I always use a thermometer because guessing doesn't always work when you're trying to reach 110. Right now we're at 90. Or no, we're not, we're at 100. So in just a minute we'll start adding everything and I'll show you how we put it together. We'll be right back. Okay, we've got our milk and water mixture at 110. In here I have got 2 tablespoons of sugar. I'm going to put that in. Once I've got it mixed up, I will add 2 tablespoons of instant yeast or regular yeast. It doesn't matter which one you decide to use. Now we'll leave this and let it set just until it starts foaming on top. And I'll be right back to show you that. Coco! Coco! That's our little goat, Coco. She enjoys looking in the kitchen window. In order to do so, she has to jump up on a table that sets out there. But she's always visiting. Okay, guys, over here, you can see our yeast has started to foam. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my bowl and I'm going to hook it on and I'm going to pour my yeast and milk into my bowl. Now to that, I will add 6 cups of flour and 2 teaspoons of salt. Now you can cut it back to 1 teaspoon of salt. I mix my salt up into my flour. And as I said, you can make that 1 teaspoon. Now I'm going to start this at 2, as soon as it's plugged in. Okay, let's try again. I'll start it at 2, and And while it's working, I'm going to add my flour a little bit at a time. As soon as I have this added, I'll be right back. Okay, now what we're watching for is our dough to pull the flour away from our bowl, which it does pretty well. We have extra flour just in case we need it, and we'll use it accordingly. Sometimes I need it, sometimes I don't. See, you can see where it's pulling it away from the bowl. It only takes a few minutes to mix this up. The nice thing about this recipe, I'm going to show you guys something. This is a loaf. This is a loaf of bread that I made 2 days ago. Usually your homemade bread will turn dry within a couple days. I love this recipe because the crust stays soft, as you can see. Press in on your bread, bounces back, and even bread that is 2-3 days old is very soft. It stays very soft. It's more like a sandwich loaf. So the recipe works very well, and it's simple. It's inexpensive. And it's great tasting. Now, as you can see, it has absorbed the flour, but it's sticking. Can you see down in here where it's sticking to the bowl? So all I do in that case is I add a little flour at a time. That was probably about 1/4 cup. And we wait for that to pull away from the bowl and get mixed into our dough. This KitchenAid is a blessing, an absolute blessing, and I intend to share a lot of recipes with you guys. It was a gift to me. I've wanted one for years and years, so I can't tell you how excited I was when I saw it. And we're gonna have to add just a little bit more. I think I'll use a different spoon for that. I can tell looking at it that it's still sticking. So we'll add about 1/8 cup more. And I'll do this continually until it pulls away from the bowl. So I'll be back to show you that. You can see it starting to pull away, but it's still quite sticky. So I'm going to add about 1/8 cup more. That'll bring us up to 1/2 cup. Of extra flour that I've added to this. We'll be right back. Okay, you can see it's pulling away, but I've still got some dough up here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lower this and turn it off, and I'm gonna take my scooper thing, whatever this is. I don't even remember what they're called, but I'm gonna wipe the edge of my bowl down into my bread. And that's just getting the rest of the flour and the extra dough. Out of the way and off the edge. It's just a little thing I always do. Now, as I'm doing that, I feel my dough and I can see that my dough is not sticking to my hand, but it's very soft. So I'll let this mix, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna let it knead with the mix, with the mixer, for a total of 7 minutes. I'll be back. Okay guys, I just wanted to show you, if you can see down in here, it's all pulled away from the bowl pretty much, except for one little tiny spot there. Now I'm gonna set the timer for 7 minutes, and I'm gonna let this continue kneading, and then you'll see how subtle and soft and beautiful and moist this dough turns out. When they say just like a baby's bottom, this is exactly what you get. We'll be back. Okay, we are done. Our timer has gone off. So now we simply pull our dough paddle and see how clean it is. And we lift our bowl. We're gonna take our bread onto the counter. It's just a little tiny bit sticky. If you look, you see how it's grabbing onto the bowl? I don't wanna go, I don't wanna go. Well, it's gonna go. Now, we take a little bit of oil. David, can you hand me the oil, please, son? And we put a drop, just a drop, in the bottom of our bowl. You can see, it's just a little bit, and I just swish it around with my hands. And then I like soft hands, so I rub my hands with the oil. And I take our bread, pick it up off the counter, turn it over. I don't know if you guys can see how soft this is, but it's remarkably soft. Very, very soft and smooth. Roll it over just like this. And now I'll cover it with cellophane, and we will put it in my microwave to raise. We want it to raise at least double. I go a little bit over double. We'll be back. Okay, friends and family, I've placed cellophane on here just loosely. I don't want it tight, because as this rises, your gases will raise, and it brings this up into a bubble. It causes its own environment in there that keeps the yeast very active. And as you can see, it's already starting to rise. So I'm gonna take this and put it inside my microwave. I'm gonna set my timer for 30 minutes and I'll be back to look at it. Sometimes it takes 30 minutes, sometimes a little more. So we'll be back. Okay, we're gonna put some oil on these pans. This was my grandmother's pan. These my mother's. And they always will be used. Always be with us. As you can see, they're well used. Now what we're going to do is we're going to get our bread out. And we'll go over to the counter and I'll show you how I make my loaves. So we'll be right back. Okay, here we go with our bread, guys. And how beautiful is that? That is beautiful bread. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna knock it all down. And then I'm going to separate it into three loaves. This will make three nice loaves of bread. once I get all the air out, I'm going to separate it into three sections. JD, can you get the bread pans, please?
Sure. Excuse me, Dave.
David is our cameraman, as always. He does an excellent job. Okay, I start by folding it over, and I do the baby tuck. I tuck and roll. 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 Now, it kind of looks like a cinnamon roll there on the end. But like everybody else, I tuck that under and I pinch. Tuck and pinch. Then I flip it over and I roll to make sure that I don't have pockets of air inside. I form my loaf according to the size of my pan, and I drop it in. I'll do these other two and I'll be right back. Okay, friends and family, here's our loaves. As you can see, they're nice and they're already rising. I'm gonna stick them in the microwave, let them rise, and then we'll put them in the oven. We'll be back. Okay, YouTube friends and family, now we set our oven for 400 and we put our bread in. So you're putting the bread in a cold oven. And we set the timer for 30 minutes, and in 30 minutes we'll have bread. We'll be back and show you the finished product. Catch you in a few. Okay, YouTube friends and family, now we butter the top, and we've made three of the smaller loaves. We also make the big loaves. And it's delicious. I wish you could smell the house right now. We got to work on that smell-o-vision. Get it going. Anyway, there's our homemade bread. David, what do you think of the homemade bread that we make?
Can I have a piece?
Yeah, you're going to get a piece. Anyway, friends and family, there we have it. And that is our recipe. Check down below in the show more for the entire recipe. What are you trying to say to me, David? You're giggling. You want a cut.
Uh-huh.
You want me to cut it.
Yeah.
It's a little too hot. You actually want me to do that? I don't think I want to do that.
Okay.
We will cut it another time, but trust me, friends and family, I don't know if you can see, it's very soft. Oh, and it's good. So, time to go back to sleep. Catch you later. Loves and hugs.